What is happening, everybody? John Denton back with another reaction. It's Migos Monday. Well, it's Monday because I'm recording on a Monday, and it's Migos Monday because I'm listening to Culture One thanks to the patrons. If you're seeing this on YouTube and you're wondering what I'm talking about, check the link down in the description. The entire support structure for this channel, every single month, 4 extra album reactions, up to 8 extra track reactions. The patrons decide what they're going to be. The support on Patreon has been unbelievable. So if you did want to come on and support the channel, then please do, and if not, just enjoy the video. I've heard a few tracks off this. It's supposed to be a classic all the way through. Let's go. That's it. Keep the intro short. Listen, I've heard enough Migos tracks, including some of the tracks from this album, to kind of know what to expect sonically. So this reaction is probably just going to be a lot of vibes, breakdowns, where they make sense. Yeah, they use these kind of like off-kilter beats, don't they? It kind of like offsets the... Offset? Dad joke 2020, maybe. Offsets the content of the lyrics and the delivery as well. Just go slide and grab on that nine when I say it's time to play. Jump in the crowd and get loud today. Fuck boy, bow down! Fuck are you talking about, DJ Khaled? Now this is the first Migos tune I heard. I believe there's a reaction to this back of Rock Reacts, early days of Rock Reacts. Trench work. Mama told me, not to sell work. Mama 17, 5, same color t-shirt, white. Get watching, so I gotta keep the rocket. Now, neck, water, faucet, water, mocking, birds, mocking, popping. All I want is cottage, roll up, cigar, full of broccoli, cookies. See, I mean, I've not even got lyrics up for this, just because I don't really see an act like Migos as like a lyrical act. It's more just about vibes, tempo, being in the pocket. I mean, they use that word pocket all the time as well because it works so well in the pocket, ironically. And yeah, this is like weird reverse sample in the beat and stuff. It just kind of transports you to a weird place. Pop it with a pocket full of cottage. Yeah. Whoa, chemo, slap it, chopper, aim it, hit your noggin. Yeah. Had to cut the attic, dinner. Yeah, it's very hypnotic music, the way that they deliver ever so slightly behind the beat deliberately. Not saying they're offbeat when I say that. That is not what I'm saying. They're definitely not offbeat. The unusual beat with the low BPM, everything like that. That's, it is hypnotic. It takes you somewhere. I had to chop it, skirt, skirt. Niggas pocket watching, so I gotta keep the rocket. Mama told me, not to sell word. Mama 17, 5, same color t-shirt, white. Mama told me, face cool, quiver, Yoda, point, drinking sodas. I get white. Mama told me, not to sell word. For me, for a song like this, it doesn't quite have the all the way to space elements of Travis Scott, right? It doesn't quite have the punch of Future. It doesn't quite have the bizarre melodies of Young Thug. But it obviously has such similarities to all of their music. Trap shit. No. Hey, put the back ends in the back. Back. Drinker on me, it's attached. Tag. Things real shack. Eat it up. Run the plug, give me tag. Sack. Sip the lean and relax. I like that little piano dancing over, again, a very otherwise kind of hypnotic. There's always someone drilling around there. Always. Otherwise kind of, again, hypnotic, kind of like low BPM, kind of annoying beat. The little piano dancing over there is giving a song a different type of energy. But overall, I'm expecting this to just be a very similar record all the way through. Gang white, call him Andy Miller Nagus. He won't hesitate to shoot him. Shoot. Private jet to Bermuda. I fuck the game, Kama Sutra. I got M's on my mind. I got boulders in my time. Put a model bitch on cocoa. I bet 100 on the crops. I'm good on shout it, do it out. She fucking niggas for the check. I'ma only get the mouth. Chop, chop, you can get them on your asking. How many chickens you can get them whichever way nigga chop turns Zaxby. Zax. I beat the... Yeah, she quite like that track. Takeoff's different key for the hook. Worked pretty well. Offset verse there at the end is pretty funny. Like, this is difficult to break down because it's not like I can sit there going, it's this bar. This bar means this and he's saying this. I mean, it's basically like, I did this, I'm going to do this. A lot of it about dealing drugs, cooking up drugs, selling drugs. It's trap music, man. I don't need to tell you what it is. You guys tell me what it is. Raindrop, drop top, smoking, no cooking, the hot pot, cooking, fucking on your bitch, yeah, that, cooking up dope in the crock pot, we came from nothing to something, nigga. Hey.
Records on records, got backers on backers. I'm riding around in a coupe. I take your beat right from you, you. Bitch, I'm a dog.
I can certainly sound so evil in those chords that are being used in the beat, off-key chords, and yet sound so bougie, sound so luxurious based on the lyrics, just based on the vibe, the video, everything like that. Quite a clever combination, man. It creates a different atmosphere, and an atmosphere that has been replicated and used with different artists and obviously a signature Metro Boomin sound. But at the same time, if you go back and listen to music before this, there's nothing really sounded like that combination of the two things. So you've got to give credit to everybody involved in creating and cultivating such an unusual sound.
Dabbing on them like the usual. Damn. Magic with the brick do voodoo.
Magic.
Court side with a bad bitch.
Bitch.
Then I send the bitch through Uber.
Go.
I'm young and rich and plus I'm bougie.
Hey.
I'm not stupid, so I keep the Uzi. Records on records, get backers on backers, so my money making my back. Ay.
So I like this song, the hook's killer, and if it came on in different circumstances, I'm always going to enjoy it. My worry about listening to this record, I mean, this song's nearly 6 minutes long. This record is nearly an hour long, and I'm worried about a lack of variety.
Yeah, getting that chicken with blue cheese, yeah. Boy, you're so fit like my collar, you snake, and I swear to God, that be that Gucci.
I like this song, I like the hook, it's way too long. It's way too long, it doesn't need to be a 6 minute track.
Get right with you, I'ma get right with you. Bad bitches, fuck up, then dismiss them. Bam.
Love the production on this track. I'm just going to accept the fact that I'm just going to have to like drift off and vibe out to this album, and also accept the fact I'm not really in the right state of mind for an album like this to go all the way through. If I was fucking drunk, this would be different, but I'm not getting drunk at 11 a.m. on a Monday. That would be terrible. That would not be acceptable behavior.
Get right with you. I'ma get right with you. Yeah. Get right with you. Pop me a missile.
Hey.
Take me a picture. Oh, believe me, believe me.
Believe me.
Get beat.
Beat.
Cause I'm flexing Rory.
Scott.
You can bet on me. Hey, hey. 10 o'clock.
Hey.
Ride round. Get up down. Think it's 3 o'clock.
Just finding the record a little dull, to be honest. It's not moving me. And you know, if you watch this channel and you've been watching my reactions for a long time and my thoughts on music will move me, I mean seriously, when it does, and sometimes it just doesn't, and I'm feeling like this is one of those times. Despite liking certain songs and certain elements of certain songs, it's a lot in a row and we're not even halfway through yet.
I'm up, oh, believe me, believe me,
believe me,
get beat, cause I'm flexing Rory's,
so persistent, if I want it, I go get it, I'm so slimy, grimy, shiesty, but still shiny,
drip, drip,
splash,
hey. Slippery.
When I switch off my brain and stop stressing about the fact that I'm supposed to say stuff, I enjoy the tracks more. I'm just allowing them to kind of wash over me a little bit more. And I think that's got to be the way. Listen, this album isn't designed to be sat there, broken down, stopped, talked about. It's designed to just be enjoyed. It's designed to almost be kind of soundtrack music, background music, vibe music. So I'm letting it be that.
If you gon' drizz, how you pull one up the seal? How you gon' do what I did? Picking up a plate of kales. Can't go big on big. We the biggest shit poppin'. Wrist water, no faucet.
I like the Zaytoven piano on this track. I kind of like the different way that the hook's being fed into the verses. It's still pretty similar to the rest of the songs, but at least it's a little bit more interesting. It's woken me up a little bit.
Keep up with the choke.
Keep up.
Eyes closed, whipping it blindfold.
If you having paper and I'm having paper, how you go big on big? If you having neighbors and I'm having acres, how you go big on big?
Okay, just hoping for a bit of a switch up because it's a long record. All of the songs are really long and I don't find it as interesting as some of the other kind of track classics that we've heard over the last few years and we've heard on this journey through music. Okay, well, it's a different instrument.
Prices going up. Prices.
Hold on.
Price. You can read between the lines like a pro spader. Did my own grind.
Been to India. Custom jet, make sure you clear me out.
Clear me out.
I generally just prefer like the mix of instruments going on here. There's a lot more hypnotic stuff going on here. It reminds me more of something Travis Scott would create because it is kind of taking me somewhere else. So close the curtain and smoking the gold. Hop in the eye and lift up the dough. Y'all rich nigga, more money than the old. And read between the lines like a pro state. I did my own grind. What's the price? What's the price? Price is going up. Yeah, I actually really like this track. Hold on. She fucking you going outside. Sad, huh? Sad. I had a dream in the pool, I was swimming through cash. Racks. Brown. Paper. Bags. Cash. Smashing your hoe on the low and she calling me dash. Cupping the bitch when she fucking you. So the song's just boring. It's boring, man. I'm sorry. Who I am? Cause I can't afford to get jammed. Cuffing bitches on spam. Nobody. All my bitches, yeah, sham. Fuck them, but you gotta pay them. Pay up. Break the bread up with the fam. The song did absolutely nothing for me. It just felt like that could have easily been cut and left on the cutting room floor. I like the breadth of the production on this track. Obviously, nothing going on lyrically. It's just one to nod your head to. A 2 Chainz feature is one of the highlights of the record, to be honest. Yeah, it's actually one of my favourite songs off the record of the ones that I haven't heard as well. A bit more atmosphere to it, a bit more depth to it. It fucking sounded evil. That 2 Chainz verse as well just gave it that little bit of variety that some of the tracks have been lacking. There's good tracks on this record. It's just too long. That's my problem with it. Bad bitch walking out with bags at the store. Bad stripper girl shaking her ass on the pole. You wanna fall, let's get it. I make you rich with a 50. And what planet does this song need to be 5 fucking minutes long? No ass on the pole. Right. Always keep some bitches on the side, yeah, yeah. Don't stand too close, my diamonds gonna bite. I get drugs for the right price, yeah, yeah. She gon' eat this molly like it's rice. Nah. Woke up cocaine all in my hair, thought it was light, yeah, yeah. Okay. Again, so long. If this record was like 38 minutes long and these songs were just chopped down, it would be so much better. It doesn't need to be 6 minutes long. It doesn't have enough to it. And this is a beat switch halfway through or something. Ooh, all this pain, we can live through it. It's called success. You always going out your way. You always dropping off your flag. You always going out your way. Never ask me to repay. No, you always going out your way. You went and went told to, so I made the song just for you. You always going out your way. You again, 5 minutes? It's so repetitive. Listen, there are plenty of moments that I like, there are plenty of parts, there are plenty of songs that I like, and there are plenty of songs that I liked, but this, to me, is a key example of less is more, and indeed more is less. All of these songs, pretty much every single one of them, could have had 1 to 2 minutes taken off their runtime and been improved. I can't think of any of the tracks on here that were made better by being that long. 6 minutes for that one with Travis Scott. 5 minutes for that one just before that? Ridiculous. At the same time, I do appreciate the kind of influence that Migos have had on music over the last 5 years, how many people have kind of like borrowed their flow. There's also an argument it's not necessarily their flow, but I'd certainly say they made it popular, the triplet flow and everything like that. But having heard plenty of music from them and plenty of music like that, I don't get that novelty listen to it at the back end of 2020. There was just no real reason for all of those songs to be that long. Shorter, sharper, get your point across. get the mood across. And if you're going to do something longer, if you're going to do an expensive song, give it reason to be expensive. Add layers, add depth to it, not just the same repetitive thing over and over and over again. I know people hold this in the same sort of esteem as a DS2 or as a Barter 6, or as even a Rhodia. Surely nobody puts it up there with that in terms of the trap classics. But for me, it just wasn't on the same level at all, despite having moments that I liked, little quotables, little moments in production, etc. Guys, if you're new around here, please do subscribe. If you're wondering what I'm talking about and you wanted to see this in uncut form, that is there on the Patreon link. Check out the link down in the description. Come follow me on social media. I'll see you in the next video, all right? Peace.